Athens. Do you hear me?
Yes, very well.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your kind words, for the presentation, for the introduction. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers, the Hellenic Bankers Association UK and the Hellenic American Professionals in Finance for giving me the opportunity to address so many distinguished members of the Greek diaspora and to exchange thoughts with all of you on how we tackle the crisis and on the challenges we face regarding the Greek economy. The current health crisis was a severe shock, as was mentioned before, for the society and the economy, not only in our country, but all around the world, since this is a symmetric, exogenous, and unpredictable rupture, causing a great deal of uncertainty. In the case of Greece, last March, this crisis caused an abrupt halt to the dynamic growth perspective that was formed since the second semester of 2019, a perspective that was the fruit of the implementation of a new policy mix based on three main pillars: on prudent fiscal policy with tax reductions, on structural reforms, and on boosting investments and privatizations. From the very first moment that the pandemic started to spread, the Greek government set as its priority, top priority, the protection of human life and public health. And this is still our first priority, as proved by the measures we are taking in the land borders. Greece has so far been a coronavirus success story, as confirmed by statistics concerning the expansion of the pandemic. Measures to limit the contagion of the virus are efficiently implemented, as Greek people demonstrated a very high sense of responsibility, social discipline, and adaptability to the extraordinary situation. These merits rendered the country a shining example and one of the safest countries worldwide. The big challenge is to make the economic circuit fully operational again, building on the basis of the aforementioned positive track record from the hygiene perspective. In order to fulfill this target, the Greek government continued taking targeted measures over the last month, thus confirming its readiness to act prudently and to minimize the social and economic consequences of the pandemic. Indeed, COVID-19 is expected to lead to a significant recession and a rise in unemployment. However, the recession would be much deeper and the rise in unemployment much higher had it not been for our comprehensive, realistic, and dynamic package of policy measures that have supported and are continuing to support public health, employment, liquidity in the real economy, and social cohesion, spreading a wide safety net over households and enterprises. This included fiscal measures, deferrals, and liquidity measures. They were adjusted to respond to the different needs arising in every phase of the crisis. Their total value is estimated at 24 billion euros, or 13% of GDP, and may increase depending on the development of the outbreak, as well as on the available fiscal and financial space of the country. For all the above, the Eurogroup, on quotes, commended the Greek authorities for the quick and decisive policy response in taking the necessary economic and fiscal support measures. Among others, during the last couple of months, we have implemented one-off VAT reduction on transports, coffee, beverages, and tourist packages. A significant reduction or even zeroing of the corporate tax advance for enterprises, depending on the decrease in their turnover. The arrangement in 12 interest-free installments or 24 installments with low interest rate for tax and social security contributions, deferrals, over the crisis, starting the repayment from 2021. Targeted measures for sectors more severely affected by the crisis, such as tourism, air, and maritime transport. Special allowances for employees and self-employed. Employment support measures, especially for seasonal companies. The second phase of the refundable advance payment to support business liquidity. A third phase is also planned for August. The goal is to reach a total of about 3 billion euros. Additional instruments for boosting business liquidity, which include the interest rate subsidy for all business loans of companies that belong to affected sectors, the working capital under the Entrepreneurship Fund 2, the famous TEPIC 2 program, and the Hellenic Development Bank guarantees. And finally, short-term employment schemes and the extension of the regular unemployment benefit. A crucial question that many times set in all our discussions is how we capture to finance all these needs. We have ensured the necessary fuels. We manage domestic resources of general government entities with prudence. We are successfully borrowing from the markets either GGBs plus 5 billion euros or T-bills plus 2 billion euros compared with the pre-COVID-19 period. We execute the budget in the best possible way. We have slippages on the revenue side, but on the other hand, we don't have a catastrophe. And we are ready to use, to the best of our ability and at the right time, the existing European financial instruments. As it has been worldwide recognized and as it was praised by the European Commission in the 6th Enhanced Surveillance Report and more recently in its summer economic forecast, the Greek government has acted with responsibility, prudency, careful fiscal management, but also promptly and effectively in addressing the pandemic crisis and limiting as much as possible the social and economic consequences. This is why the European Commission's forecast revised its estimates for this year's recession in Greece from around 10% to 9%, while its estimates for Europe and the euro area were revised to deeper recession. Apart from all the above, even under the pressure and the unprecedented circumstances of the outbreak, we continue to implement structural reforms and to promote investments in order to enhance productivity and structural competitiveness of the Greek economy. Among others, the reduction of NPLs on banks' portfolios. Indeed, a systematic bank, Eurobank, has already completed the process to participate in the famous Hercules scheme. A new insolvency code with several safeguards to filter strategic defaulters in order to tackle private debt. Just yesterday, a new bill for corporate governance and the modern capital market was voted with high participation from all political parties by the parliament with a significant majority. This bill also included a series of amendments and measures boosting important privatizations, such as the famous Hellenicon project, and some port authorities, like Alexandroupoli, Kavala, and Volos, as well as the restructuring of state-owned enterprises and the liquidity support to businesses in the borderland, in Thaki. The implementation of the asset development plan, despite the adverse market conditions, significant progress has been made in the privatization process for DEPA or for the Alimos Marina. The ongoing digital transformation of the public sector, which will serve to further ease the administrative burden for households and enterprises. The continuous implementation of our reform agenda. In this context, concerning just the Ministry of Finance, the new bill introducing microfinance was recently voted the previous week by the Parliament, and a new draft law, including growth-friendly tax measures, among others a non-DOM for pensioners, was under public consultation until yesterday and will be soon, most probably on Friday or Saturday, submitted to the Parliament. Other ministries promote their own structural reforms, like the draft bill for electric mobility. Going forward, I spent my presentation on what we did over the COVID-19 crisis, but going forward, our priority is to achieve high and sustainable growth and to improve its composition. The composition of growth is very important. Greece faced for many years a significant investment gap. We have to close it. In this direction, we are setting forth two interrelated objectives. The first is how we will close the negative output gap, safeguarding at the same time responsible public finances. And the second, how we will improve the economy's supply side, in other words, its productive capacity, in order to achieve sustainable and inclusive growth rates with a high level of social cohesion, addressing also demographic challenges. To achieve these objectives, we have ambitious plans for the period ahead. Our policy priorities include, among others, the implementation of a prudent fiscal policy, building on Greece's fiscal credibility, which took a lot of effort, incorporating the gradual reduction of tax rates and mainly social contributions. The strengthening of the banking sector, including non-performing loans reductions. The ongoing digital transformation of the public sector. The continuous implementation of the government reform agenda. For example, we will set for ban of single-use plastics, a modern, environmental-friendly waste management strategy, and investments in endogenous source of growth, like education, research, and innovation. The implementation of structural reforms covering the regulatory framework for doing business, the justice system, the clearance of arrears, the management of PIB, public investment budget, the rural policy, and finally, investment in infrastructure, focusing on green economy. We have set ambitious goals in our national energy and environment strategic plan. We're ensuring fair financing from the just transition mechanism. And we're discussing with our colleagues the gradual adoption of green budgeting principles. Ladies and gentlemen, the efficient way of tackling the health crisis made Greece a model, offered the country high credibility abroad, and citizens regained their trust to the state. All the above constitute an invaluable capital for the post-COVID-19 era, a capital that this government will definitely use as its best. Along with the aforementioned policy plans, completing and implementing the national growth strategy that we are preparing, just yesterday, an interim report on this was presented by Professor Pissarides and his colleagues. We will have the potential not only to recover, but to gain a strong, sustainable, inclusive growth, which will lead to attracting important investments and creating new high-quality jobs. 2021 can be a year of strong rebound. In order to make this happen, we stand ready to utilize every available domestic and European instrument and resource, especially the recovery fund. I hope that Europe will reach brave and drastic decisions on the formation, the funding, and the operational rules of this fund soon, even tomorrow and Friday, in order for countries to get access for funds starting from early 2021. The plan submitted by the Commission is sufficiently ambitious, rational, and growth-friendly, and at the same time, flexible, realistic, and in line with the challenges we are facing. It is up to us all to turn this crisis into an opportunity of restart and to become an example of the catch-up effort by building a new, healthy, sustainable, and inclusive growth model. A model free of the burdens of the past and commensurate with our responsibility towards next generations. I am convinced that we have the plan, the ability, the experience, the skills, and the determination to make it. Thank you very much.